Yes.
Okay, I just went through now saying books in the back rooms are free.
Books at the back of the room are free. One of the reasons why you should come to our meetings.
Michael brought some candy in his five books, and that's free too.
Lots of free stuff back there. Apparently, no one wants a tote carried at the end of the meeting.
Well, we always accept donations.
You're always welcome to give the society money anytime you wish. But I have to say, we have some very nice members that are providing for everyone here. That's really, that's great.
Wonderful. And now it's my pleasure to introduce to you our speaker for this evening, Dr. Jim Brown. Dr. Brown has known everyone in this room for longer than the CAS, because I think he was probably around at the time of the founding. Would that be correct, Jim? So it's a long time. But beyond that, certainly, I'd be derelict if I didn't mention that Dr. Brown has a very prestigious position at Northwestern University in the Department of Anthropology. He's well versed on the subject. He's an archaeologist. And without ado, Dr. Jim Brown.
Thank you, Bob. I have to apologize for my hoarse voice. I have an affliction. I was taking a bunch of pills to ease that affliction. But in the meantime, I have to struggle with a very, very scratchy voice. It's not my normal voice at all. Today I want to talk about my favorite subject of late, and it has to do with the town site of Cahokia, located near East St. Louis, in the context of civilization, the concept of civilization. Located. can see right away that Mount 34 is in the shadow of Mons Mound, which is that high eminence in dead center in the image. And it is almost due east, stretching to the sunrise in the morning. For some notion of where the visitor center is, because this is an old image, it's way over here in the right hand corner. Okay, no. It means you don't have a quick time. Okay, the concept, the application of the concept of civilization is not new. In fact, it was pushed forward in a very serious way in the recent exhibit that was posted by, sponsored by the Art Institute of Chicago. And this particular exhibit, which has a very nice catalog, push it because I have a little contribution towards it, consistently looks at the roles of Native Americans in creating something rather unique and something that, in the cultural way, that compares nicely with what went on, say, in Mexico or in the Maya lowlands or even further south. And here you see a bit of an image created in a style which has its home in the Cahokia and its surrounding area. It's been commonplace talk about the Cahokia as rising suddenly around 1050 AD. The precise date is something that we shouldn't linger on too much. Much to say, it's somewhere in the middle of the 11th century. And you can see by this map that the early pre-1050 spread of occupation was this long kind of hot dog with the bulging ends that sat along a ridge. And then suddenly there was an extension that was elaborated both to the north and the south that extended very extensively. I might point out that as extensions are important because not only did it spread as a result of, say, a population expansion or because of design, but it also represents something else, and that is a deliberate filling of the landscape. So what you see today looks like a beautiful picnic lawn stretching out beautifully, but would you believe almost every meter of that surface been put in place by Native Americans, because what underlies that spread of inky stuff was a rigid swale, a washboard that required leveling and infilling. And not only what did they spread soil once, they often dug it out and then refilled it again. So it was a deliberately created landscape which to many eyes looks like nothing more than a picnic ground. But see the spread, and it's very important because it created a kind of diamond in particular kinds of mounds. Won't go into that, but 1050 turns out to be very, very important. Come on. About two centuries later, there's other changes that take place, and I'm going to describe here in detail. And I won't go down the list, but merely point out that they represent not just a dramatic change in the spread of a town, but changes that are internal to cultural development.